Here at 6, explosive testimony today from Caltrans whistleblowers and a state senator accused of accusing the agency, I should say, of covering up safety concerns over construction of the Bay Bridge. KCRA3's Michael Lurie joins us now with a closer look at the bridge traveled by, boy, hundreds of thousands of Californians every day, Mike.
That's right, Kelly. You know, the Bay Bridge partially collapsed 25 years ago during the World Series between the Giants and the A's. That was the catalyst to make major repairs. But the retrofit, much of it built in China, is years late and $5 billion over budget, with safety concerns raised today at the Capitol by Caltrans insiders.
We knew that there were cracks in all the deck panels.
Whistleblower witnesses from Caltrans testifying today at the state Capitol. They said their concerns about safety testing on the newly reconstructed Bay Bridge were ignored by supervisors.
I was specifically directed not to look in areas that I knew there were cracks.
Welding concerns were overlooked, they said, and charges that bridge fabricators in China actually used the wrong steel on the anchor rods.
Quality assurance was, I have to say, abysmal, because there's no way that those rods should have been accepted without further testing.
Also testimony today about some of the early batch of the bolts for the Bay Bridge that ended up being rejected.
Senator, it's always alarming when you hear of anything failing.
But for senators on the transportation panel, the biggest failure may have been allegations that Caltrans tried to bypass the Public Records Act by instructing personnel to avoid making written records of anything sensitive.
But is there a cover-up?
I would be inclined to think there has been.
It is safe. Quality was not compromised.
But Caltrans Director Malcolm Dougherty came out swinging today, fighting back against the whistleblowers.
I have no evidence or no reason to believe that there was any coercion or anything like that and bullying to make determinations. These are differences in engineering opinions.
The director stated Caltrans would never have opened the Bay Bridge last September if there were any questions about bridge safety. But the whistleblowers conceded the Bay Bridge as it stands today is safe. They had some serious questions, though, about whether it will truly last 150 years, as Caltrans claims. The whistleblowers contend that bridge may need major retrofits well before that.
So they made their points today. What's the next step in all this?
Well, first off, a hearing, another Senate hearing, this one coming up in next month in February, and then two more government reports, including one by the Legislative Analyst Office. So this issue is far from over.
A lot more to learn there. All right, Mike, thanks for